with y'all. Praise the Lord. We're going to go ahead on with our affirmation of faith. Reverend is going to come up. Reverend Timothy Bill is going to come up. Get us started on this affirmation of faith. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
All right, Reverend. Okay. Yes, sir. Jesus Christ searches the heart, knows what the mind of the Spirit is, because he made intercession for the saints according to the will of God. And we know that all things work together with those who love God, those who are called according to his purpose. But whom he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, that he might be firstborn among many brothers. But whom he predestined, these he also called. Whom he called, these he also justified. Whom he justified, these he also glorified. What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own Son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not freely give us all things? Who shall bring a charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is he to condemn? It is Christ the God. And for above all is also risen, who is even at the right hand of God, who also made intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or perils or war? As it is written, for your sake, we'll kill all day long, we'll count as sheep for the slaughter. Yet in all these things, we're more than conquerors of your love. For I am afraid that you may death my life, my angels, my principalities, my powers, my things present, my things to come. My height, my depth, my any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. I believe we got another selection from the choir.
Amen.
Okay, we're
going to
go ahead
and sing Silent Night. Okay. Oh. Hallelujah.
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 beautiful. Now we're going to go ahead and have our announcements. Thank you, choir.
Good morning, everyone.
Morning.
Good afternoon, everyone. All right. We're celebrating Jesus Christ's birthday. Hasn't gotten in yet, but I'm still feeling it already.
Amen.
I'm already feeling it. All that wonderful singing and
yes.
music and people gathering together now. Okay, I'm looking at next year. Okay. But here we go. This is December, second Sunday of December. As you know, it's our dress down service scarves. That's why we have all our scarves on. So in a minute or two, we'll be telling you what our scarves are about. You know, if someone's giving you a scarf, what it make you think of, or you know, whatever you remember any scarf. You know, some people like the scarf and hat thing and the gloves. I always wore those. People always gave me those. So I always had some. Anyway, let's move on right quick before we get to our dress down day thing. I'm so grateful in Sunday school today. We were talking about how people misunderstand the king that was being born. You know, they misunderstand the lowly Jesus who came in on a donkey. But during peace, that's what represents peacetime, kings ride on. When they was doing war, they were riding horses because they was getting ready to fight, you know. And you know, they look at Jesus the wrong way about everything, you know. And even now today, people still don't see Jesus. See, some people don't recognize Jesus. They say, oh, I believe in God, and they don't believe in Jesus Christ. So, you know, Jesus died for our sin. He gave us that chance that we may have a chance for everlasting life.
Amen.
And it's just so wonderful, Isaiah 9:6, one of the beautiful things that he's called. It's just so wonderful. So we're going to second Sunday, Christmas CCE, our community celebrations event. We do have bags. I'm getting some bags. I'm trying to get them done. And our Sunday school superintendent said, well, what are we going to do? What are we going to do for that? And I said, well, you know, so you got those bags. So, you know, go ahead and try to put the bags together. What you got to do to take care of the bags and go from there. And that's what we were doing this morning after Sunday school.
Amen.
We put our bags together. We'll be looking for donations to put something in the bag and give it to the elderly. Working on this, so you guys. So I was letting people know. And also, we're going to be doing our Christmas celebration. It's our Christmas sister and our Christmas brother. So you turn your little Christmas sheet in, you turn that in, you put it into the envelope, unmarked envelopes, and then you disperse it out, and you will have somebody, hopefully they fill it out, they tell you what they want, they just send them back about different things. I got to tell them about this stuff when they want, because I can't read their minds. But that'll help us out. You know, I already told you, but that savings account, Christmas brother, okay? You know, so you already got it. All in my head, I'm just going, you already have it, already ready. You're just waiting on the paper. That's all it is. You got to have faith. What you saying now? Mom, church. And great. Get in faith. You got to have faith.
Anyway, I'm just thinking for this. That's what came to my mind. So if you
somebody gave you something, give you something, whatever come to your mind, the spirit that's in that, you know. So I'm just thinking praise about the stars and stuff. Is anyone else?
Well, I don't really have a significance to my scarf. I just bought it at the store a couple years ago. So around Christmas time, I say, hey, you know, go to a program, whatever, get your scarf. So, you know, red, white, and green Christmas stuff. So.
Thank you. Amen. Praise the Lord. Yep.
I'm a soldier in the army of the Lord. I'm a soldier in the army. I'm a soldier in the army of the Lord. I'm a soldier in the army. I'm a soldier in the army of the Lord. I'm a soldier.
Yes, he is. Not so much don't need my materialistic things out there. Father, God, help us to put you first in our life daily, Father. Help us to put down the things that hinder the mind, the body, the soul, the counsel, our spirit. Father God, we need you right now, Father. We need you daily in our prayer. We need you daily when we wake up, Father God. We need you day and night, Father God. We need you everywhere, all day, all night, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, Father God. We need that Holy Spirit, Father God. We need that comforter. The comfort us at a time of our struggle, Father God. Comfort us in our need, Father. That we need to seek you more, Father. To do things your way, not man, but your way, Father God. Help us to be more Christ-like. Help us to put down the things that we have a problem with, Father.
Hallelujah.
So, Father, we are not perfect, Father. But before we are striving for your perfection to do better.
Power right now, Father. I got someone to save me. You know, I ain't talking about the Army, the Navy, the Coast Guard, and all these people. I'm talking about Jesus Christ. That's my Savior. That's our Savior. And that is something, because why? He loves me. And I can tell everyone, he loves you too. And I don't care if you're homeless, I don't care if you're out there doing all these things or whatever. I can say Jesus loves you. Somebody is just about to put a healer in their arm, okay? Drugs, whatever. I say, you know, Jesus loves you. He didn't say, well, I just love the people who come to church all the time, shout and pray my name. He loves us all, the just and the unjust. That's the beauty of Jesus Christ. And you have a chance to get saved right now. I mean, it's open. It's open doors. You can come in anytime you get ready. Because Jesus is going to put his loving arms around you. He'll put his loving arms around me. The same, I'm the same as you. I'm not no better than anyone else.
Yes.
The only person that needs to look up to is Jesus Christ. Don't look up to these movie stars and these rappers and all these people that are saying, I'm big time, I'm big shot, I got the biggest house, I got the biggest car, I got the finest, I got all the money. And people look up to that. No, that's the world. Put your eyes on Jesus. That's what you need to look up to. And I thank Jesus for that. Jesus heals more than our physical body. People don't know that. You know, they think about the part about Jesus healed the mind, the day, all that. Yeah, he did. But Jesus healed more than the physical body. Jesus takes care of our emotion.
Yes, he does.
Our social.
Yes.
Our psychological problems. Needs as well. There's people got psychological problems. He will save you. He will help you. Okay, the Bible mentioned other aspects of the mind that and the heart that Jesus takes care of. For example, he takes care of our anxiety.
Amen.
Okay, let's talk about anxiety.
Amen.
Anxiety is a big thing now.
Right.
And that is taking a lot of people out. Anxiety is a disease. Some people didn't know what anxiety is. A disease? It's a condition. Some people can't take control of anxiety. Let me tell you, anxiety is a sign. This is a sign. They're feeling nervous. Okay? Restless. Tense. Okay? They have a sense of impaired danger. Okay? Panic. And doom. They feel, you know, just like down all the time. And they have increased heart rate. Oh, yeah, it's something to bring your whole heart rate lower. Breathing rapidly, hyperventilation. You'll be doing all these things, sweating, trembling, feeling weak, tired, because when anxiety is going to take over your body. And then trouble, concentrating on thinking about anything other than the present. You're worrying about everything. That same problem is worrying you all the time. You can't get your mind to move on to something else because why? You're focusing on that problem.
Amen.
That one problem is bothering you. That's anxiety.
Yeah.
Okay? Think about the same thing over and over. Okay? This is out of control. We are in the devil's territory.
Amen.
Did you know that? We're starting to be in the devil's territory. The devil's just pulling us like rope. You know how you get rope? Well, come on. The anxiety attacks. Because if you know these people, they are out of control. You know? You can see them, their emotion, their body, the physical body. They say, what's wrong with you? You know, I'm okay. I'm going to know they can walk fast. You know, like they hurt. Because why? We have a Savior, and his name is Jesus at least one stand. Okay, do. Okay, that's first reading. No, that's. It looks like Romans.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's okay. We want First Peter. And we want chapter 5, verse 7.
Hold on.
Five and anyway, like I said, it's
right.
Put my eyes on that. I would ride around the bicycle if I have to.
You know, because if that's what God gave me, see, a lot of people say, oh, wow, don't go that low, you know. Yeah. I mean, whatever God has for me is for me. I don't know what it is, but it is for me. So, hey, I just don't get into all that stuff. We can't concentrate on all that kind of stuff. Now, Jesus give us peace. We done had about anxiety and all this stuff, but then God give us peace. I leave you my peace. Now, that's Jesus' peace, not Sharon's peace. I can't give you no peace. And nobody else can give you no peace. Amen. I don't care who you have in your life, they cannot give you no peace like Jesus. Jesus is the only one who can give us peace. Not as the world. You know he said that? Not as the world. The world give you peace with, hey, come on here, child. Tell me about your problem. Hey, what you like? You like cognac or you like some whiskey? Or what you want? Let's talk about these problems. That's the kind of stuff they go to talk about. Yeah, come on, let's sit at the table. Yeah, child, you know. Yeah, why don't you sniff on some of this here, you know. We get some peace around. No, that's the world peace. You see, we don't want that kind of peace. So a lot of people get that mixed up. No, not like that. Drinking and having, you know, doing all these things. No, not like the world. Let not your heart be troubled. Neither be let them be afraid. Don't be afraid of what God. Let's go to John 14:1, Pastor.
All right.
That's what I'm going to. Therefore, since we have been justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Savior Jesus Christ. That's the only way we're going to get peace. And we got one verse to look at. And that you can see that this ain't made up story. This is for real in the Bible. And God said he can give you peace. And I believe that. I believe that. I've been calling him so many times. And he like it. He always say, it don't matter how many times you call me. Just call me. He don't care. I don't want to bother. Yeah, I want to bother Jesus. I want to bother him. Okay? I'm going to talk to him anywhere, everywhere I can go. I need you, Lord. I need you now, 24 hours. His line is never busy. Okay? And he never puts you on hold. Okay? So, well, you know, hey, Jesus, I want to talk to you today. Well, yeah, I got another client on the phone. Hold on for a minute. I'll get back with you. Answer machine come on and say, this is Jesus hotline. Just leave your name and number and I get back with you. We don't have that. We don't have that with Jesus. You can call, I don't care, millions of people. He can listen to all of us at once. That's just how powerful he is. And you know, he comes to our troubles and our needs. Okay, we have it. All right, I was talking while we getting that going. That's John 14:1. John chapter 14 and verse 1. That's fine. We're going to read that so we can understand. Now, this, like I say, this ain't coming from Sharon. This coming from the Bible.
You want 14, okay.
Okay, we got 14 and 14. Now we're going to 1. We're there. Okay, we got. Well, that's 2. We're going to go up.
That's it?
Okay, yeah, bring that up a little bit. All I think everyone, that's probably fine. Okay, well, we're going to get it. It said, let not, everyone see that?
Yeah.
Let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God. Also in me. In my father's house are many mansions. If there were not so, I would have told you. Okay, and he's saying that he's going to prepare a place for us. Now, that's a future plan for us, and I love it. I believe it. I didn't believe that. That's the future plan for you, for all of us. That's what he said. Don't let your heart be troubled. Let me get out of that anxiety attack. All that anxiety that the devil is causing on us. We want to get out of that picture. We're thinking and believing and watching God. Because you know what? You ain't got a house here like you want on earth. You have one in heaven. Because he said, in my father's house, I'm in it, man. And that's an everlasting house. See, you ain't got to worry about getting a roof every 20 or 30 years. You see what I'm saying? Or trying to get new furniture. Or even having somebody come clean your house up. You see, you ain't got to have none of that. See, that house is everlasting. We need to start thinking about that sometimes. See, our minds so deep down into the world. And in your mind, you'll be able to see that he owns everything. And there's nothing impossible that he can't do. See, when you move away from looking at the world, you know, the hospitals are full. They are full. They got to get in line to get in the hospital. You know, I mean, they got to open up offices. You know, some people, where they work at in the office, some of them places got to be open up and throw up and put beds in there because there's so much sickness. You see, but God, we don't have to do that. We ain't going to never have to do that. That's why I look at it and say, well, what's going on in the earth now? I ain't got to worry about that in the next level. I don't have to worry about those things because I know God. He said he's going to what?
Prepare a place.
Me, for you, all of us. So that's what we need to keep our mind on. And that's the peace that God has given us. Do you see the peace? Ain't no need to lose my mind and going in a cuckoo house. You know, ain't no need to do all that stuff. Because God, if you do what God say, you will have some peace in your heart, in your mind. And the anxiety attack will go away. You know, you'll be able to control. God will control that anxiety attack. You call on him, he gonna come down, he gonna get that anxiety attack away.
Amen.
He gonna say, you better move with me. You gonna say, yeah, Jesus, I remember you say, get thee behind me, Satan, and that's what you gonna be saying. And when you look around, all that stuff is gone. Because that stuff is there to take you out. Remember that. Now we're gonna go regress. Okay. You used to tell someone to stop talking about something. Some people say, that, oh, just stop. They want to get rest. They go like, oh, just stop talking. You know, they're tired of hearing you. Get a bit of rest. Y'all heard those words before? They're talking all the time. Get a bit of rest. I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear none of that. I'm here to rest. This is my time to rest. I like going to the spa. That is rude. When you talk to people like that, okay? You don't talk to people like, you know, hey, do the hand. I don't want to hear. This is my time to rest.
Talk to the hand.
Okay? That's not the way to get Jesus is talking about getting rest. You're supposed to use this a different way. And it repeatedly throughout the scripture began with the creation. In Genesis chapter 2, verse 1, it tells us about how God rests. And how God rests, we see that God created everything in what? 6 days. He did, and then what? He said on the seventh day, we will rest. He rests. But then that type of rest is, look at all the fruits of your labor. Look at all the things that you have, you did, doing stuff with church, or whatever you're doing, and then you look back at it and say, wow, that's the way you get some rest. You're pleased at what you're doing. You're pleased at what you did for God. When God asked you to do something, you did it. You're pleased with it. You say, I did that. And you can get your rest from all your hard work you laid. Yes, you're supposed to rest. Rest your nerves, but don't be rude with it. Don't be telling people, hey, I got a note on the door. This is my resting time. Shut the door. No, you don't do that. You're supposed to be, relaxing, and God gives you that rest. It gives you a good night's sleep, too. If you depend on the Lord, he gives you a good night's sleep. Let me tell you something. Spiritual benefit of resting are also profound. When you slow down and get quiet, you can actually begin to hear your own wisdom. Did you know that? You can begin to hear your wisdom, your inner knowledge. Just get a place in night and be quiet, and then you can realize that's where your wisdom comes in. We ask God for what?
Wisdom.
Okay? And when you sit down, you'll be able, if you got a problem, whatever's going on, you will be able to solve it because God give you what?
Wisdom.
When you get that wisdom, you sit down and you can look at your problem solving with wisdom. And you got your rest, and you can look at that and say, I can solve that problem like that. Because why? You do it the way God said. And that's when you can acknowledge who you are. That's so important. That is so important. You need to take this and eat it up, y'all. I'm telling you, I'm eating it up. I'm eating it up. I'm telling you, I'm eating this up. I got breakfast, lunch, dinner, snack on this him. Because God is showing me how to rest, how to get peace in my life, how to get real anxiety. You see that? We're going to come through a lot of things. It's all the time. Take it home and run with it. Because this is some good information, especially what's going on in the world today. The world today is in trouble. But we're not in trouble because why? We have Jesus. He saved us from all this. We don't have to worry about all this stuff that's going on. I can give everything to the Lord, and he will take care of it. Because I'm not going to have this hard to breathe problems, and my heart rate gone up, my blood pressure went up, and all this and all these doctors giving me all these pills to calm my nerve, and my anxiety attack, and it still ain't gone away because I'm still got the anxiety shakes. You know, wait a minute now. I'm not going to do that because why? Why this stuff ain't working? Because it's, you ain't got Jesus in your life. You know, when you look around, I'm not going back to the cuckoo house. No, I'm not going back there. No, I'm not going back to rehabilitation. You know, I'm not going to all those things. Because why? Those are not my savior.
You ain't never been.
Okay?
Amen.
That's not my savior. My savior is Jesus Christ. And if these people put this in their mind, their life will get better. Amen. We need to stop this. We need to go into 2022. We need to stop this. Whatever went on all them years with your anxiety, you can't get no rest, you can't get no peace. Let's stop this right now. Okay, because we're praying that the Lord bring us into January. That way we can walk the way God wants us to walk, talk the way he wants us to talk, and go on that path that he got us for. He got us going into this straight path. And all he said is keep my commandment. Follow me. Let's stop following other roads that say dead end, dead end. Let's go the highway, what they call it? Highway to heaven. Let's keep walking the way God wants us to walk. Because that's the only way we're going to be able to control all these things that's going on that the world is showing. Now we got joy. And we coming into our conclusion of today, but we're going to go with joy. A lot of people don't realize that God gives us joy.
Amen.
Okay, yes, you're supposed to have joy even in times you're having trouble. You're supposed to say, yeah, I'm all right. Yeah, girl, child, please. I got this joy down in my heart. You know, I'm telling you, that's going to help you. The Bible said the joy of the Lord is your strength.
Amen.
That's when you get your strength from, everybody. When you got that joy, you got some power. Because why? You ain't let your body is so excited, so happy.
Yeah.
Your spirit, your soul, everything is happy and joyful. You ain't nothing but a part of God. But why are you so happy? Oh, I can tell you a lot of things. You got time? The sun is shining. The sky is blue.
Yeah.
I mean, the grass is green. Yeah. And so are you. I'm just saying, you can like really get down and tell people, they'll say, go into 2022.
Amen.
Be more joyful. Be more happy.
Yeah.
Even I don't care what it is coming in, I'm happy. Praise God.
Yeah.
You know, we got to have that joy in our heart because this is what Jesus is telling us. That's our strength. Nehemiah chapter 8 verse 10. And this Bible says God give us joy and peace. He gives all this stuff. Woo! Y'all need to absorb it. We need to absorb all this that God gives us. He, and it tells us the real joy comes from God. And it's forever, y'all. Once you get this joy in you, it's going to keep going on. It's not never going to leave you. It's never going to leave you because that joy is there from God. And we want that. We got, okay, we gonna get that. Don't worry about it. I just want you, you know, you can go home, write it down, Nehemiah chapter 8, verse 10. And God talks about the joy. And that's what we need to know about. God has joy. And joy, let me see, Jesus is still laughing. We want to go on with that. Pastor, you almost got it?
Yeah, I'm right.
Move on? Okay. Jesus is still laughing. A lot of people don't understand. Jesus is still laughing. He is laughing. He is smiling. He's not sad. He's not up there sad. He's so joyful. He did exactly what the Father said to do. I mean, that's something to be happy. Everybody was so joyful when he came up into the heavens. Oh, man, he done. Oh, wow, look at my son. He did a wonderful job. He's King of Kings, Lord of Lords. He just did his work just exactly. He said, I'm about my Father's business. And he was, and he did so much. And everybody was so joyful. The angels are joyful. There's no sad angels up in heaven. There's no sad angels up in heaven. They are smiling and worshiping and praising God. Look at us walking around with these sad, lonely faces. Oh, my heart was broken. So what? Jesus was down here. He got beat all day long, all night. You know, hey, let's get this joy in our heart.
Yes,
so
Lord.
Deep down in your heart. I love that song. I got this joy, 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 joy down in my heart. Down in my heart. Y'all remember that? Down in my heart. I got the joy.
What we're talking about is how
And God was telling them to go ahead and eat and be happy. And that is being joyful, how you gather together and you be happy about the Lord Savior Jesus Christ, how the wonderful things that he's doing for us. And that's what these people were doing. They were celebrating. And they were so happy. And so that's why it was showing us how to be joyful. And don't be, when things, troubles coming our way, don't get down. Don't get distressed. Let's get ourselves and get our hearts to be joyful and be happy. Because you have to understand when the words of God, it brings us happiness and joyful in our hearts. And not only that, did you know that joy in your heart, that's a healing?
Amen.
That is a healing in our body. And that's what is showing that your bones and your marrow was healed because of why you be joyful into the Lord. That, a lot of people wonder sometimes, they go like, well, I got this problem, I got that problem. But if you get into the Word of God, your body can be healed. And these things will make your body be healed. That's to give your life rest, peace, and giving everything to God. That gives us our healing power. That's the one that gives us our strength. Remember, say, joy of the Lord is your strength,
yes.
Is our strength. And that will heal your body. I'm just trying to tell you something now. That will heal our bodies.
Amen.
If you can get the Word of God and your elders going to have a major headache or whatever, cramping or something that's going on, that foreign evilness, I call it foreign parts that come in your body from the devil, because that's all it is. He always causes something in your body to try to go wrong so you can't serve the Lord. But when you put the Word of God inside your spirit, that body is going to be healed. I'm telling you, it might not come right away. It might do.
Yeah.
Now, I'm not sure. It's up to God. But then it's going to come around. It's going to come. But see, sometimes it be don't come right away because of our disbelief. So we got to ask God for, oh God, please help me in my belief so I can take care of this problem that I have. Okay? And I'm telling you, and once you put the Word of God in your heart and you be peaceful, rest, and joyful, you're going to get that healing.
Amen.
Healing
Amen.
And joyful. Joy is faith.
Amen.
Okay? When you got that faith, you're going to be joyful. You ain't going to walk around with faith with sadness.
No.
Oh, I got faith. I got faith.
Yeah, I got faith. I can move the mountain.
All right, now.
Wow, you sure showing it. You know? What kind of faith is that? No, that is a sad faith. You coming in grooming and, oh, yeah, I had a rough day, but you know, I trust in the Lord. What kind of attitude is that?
Don't know.
That you know, and what that's going to do to help other people. Boy, I tell you, they ain't trusting, man, trusting their God. Look at that. You know, because people serve Buddha better than they serve Jesus.
Amen.
Yeah. They go there and give them. I know one time I went to the nail salon. I'll tell y'all a story. I'm closing. But I'm going to tell you something. I went to the nail salon. I got my nails done. And, you know, are young people. Okay, so they had a Buddha, big old Buddha sitting up there. Beautiful apples, bananas, and strawberries, and all that stuff. You know, I didn't really pay attention. I said, well, I should be going. You know, sometimes you walk in, you want to get your nails done, and you don't look around and surround. Because actually, if I would look around my surroundings, I'd say, this ain't the right place for me. But see, I was so busy going, I didn't get my nails done. So I went on in there, and then I sat down. And then this lady, she, after she got her nails and toes done, she said she paid for her nails and stuff. Then she went over there to Buddha.
And she got that fine apple. Went out there eating. You ought to see them people in there. They stopped doing nails.
Ooh, she ain't just talking to Buddha.
Hello.
But they were out of my fit.
Right.
Oh man, I looked at them people, I said, what's going on? Boo-boo-boo-boo-boo. Man, they was really upset. I mean, they was making phone calls. They ladies stopped doing my nails. And I was like, oh, yeah. And they, I guess, the elder person probably told them what to do.
Yeah.
They all calmed down. And then somebody went in the back and got another apple and put back up there. Then they went on about their business. Now you see how they treat that belly, that big thing sitting up there, Buddha? You see how they do that statue? But then we can't do the same thing for Jesus.
Tell the truth.
What's wrong?
Tell the truth.
You know, that's a graven image? That ain't nothing. You know? And anyway, I wouldn't want, but the lady didn't know. She just went on and got an apple native. So, but that was, I bet she come back there, they made sure they told her, don't touch that. Okay? So, but see, they's real strict. But we're not strict. We just accept anything. Whatever, you know? And that's something we need to check ourselves with. In 2022, we're gonna get better, right? Everybody, we're gonna get better. We're in the wellness clinic right now. And we're gonna get better for 2022. We're gonna be there and ask the Lord to keep saving us and helping us.
Yeah.
Like I said, Jesus still left. Joy is rejoicing. Our simple, a choice we make daily. That's joyful. We have to make that choice daily. When you get up out of bed, are you happy? Are you sad? Okay. Well, you'll go like, oh boy, it's time to go to work. Amen. Yeah, but thank God he woke me up. Let's think about this part. My husband always said, thank you, Jesus, for waking me up this morning.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you, Lord. Let me get some very morning saying it.
Amen.
Amen. Get me so happy. Woo! I'm glad to live to see another day.
Yeah.
You know, and they don't want to do it, but they got to do it. That's the power of God. You know that they don't want to do it, but they got to open the door for you. They got to say, come on in. Yeah, you got to get this mom. I got to move for you.
It ain't got no choice. Touch us. He laughed at the enemy. It's funny because the enemy
forgot that God created everything. God owns everything. The enemy is crazy, confused. He got anxiety. He is sick in the head. Okay? You see, and he want to put everybody else with him. But see, everybody got to understand God is in control, and he laughed at our enemies. He laughed when they come after us to try to attack us. Because that's why he told you, your enemy would be your footstool. And he laughed. Because if your Jesus is laughing about it, you can laugh. You know the enemy come up and he talks to you all kind of like they said Job did that how the enemy, you know, Job wasn't worried about nothing.
Oh, yeah.
He wasn't worried about a thing.
Oh,
yeah. It was, you know, because he know that God was gonna take care of him.
Right.
And that's the same way we have to be, you know? Because when that you know that enemy, you know, we feel enough in church and we read the word of God enough that we can recognize. He comes in any color, any form, in any fashion. He don't care. He comes wherever he knows you. Remember, we had a pastor had a message one time about how the enemy knows you. He studies you.
Amen.
He studies your ways.
Right.
He's always looking at you.
Everything.
What you like and what you don't like.
Amen.
He's all he knows so much about you.
Yeah.
He sits back, he says, he always doing it. So he knows you a lot. He knows you.
Yeah.
So he knows what you like and dislike. But see, he won't know you at all when you have Jesus there.
Amen.
He don't want to know you.
All right.
He is afraid of you. He can't come near you. Because why? Jesus is there. He ain't going to come nowhere close to Jesus. Because he's here. He knows he has a short period of time on this earth. And when you say your numbers are limited, he gets even scared. Because he don't know when God going to put him at the bottom of the pit. He don't know when God going to stuff him down and he won't be able to move no more. He is so scared. You know how scared the devil? And he's on crack.
All right, now.
He's on crack, man.
Yeah.
He's crazy. Yeah. He's a lunatic.
All right.
That's what we're dealing with. So that's why we need help from God.
Right.
We need to keep our eyes open. And God gives us the tools. He said, watch.
Yep.
As well as pray.
Yep.
Watch.
Amen.
You can look.
Amen.
Sit back some time. Don't be so quick to move.
All right.
Hey, sit back a little bit. Check it out.
What the
word? And look at it. And say,
mm-hmm.
I see him. I'm looking right at him.
All
right. Jesus be talking to you. There you go. Yeah, Lord, I see him. That's how you can get things better in your life.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know a lot of people, and it was myself, I wanted to be a good husband. I did.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, I told you. I prayed about it and asked the Lord, because I'm telling you, you get some guy, who is that man? He come out right, start out right, but you go down the road a little longer, it ain't right, you know. But I said to God, I said, look for a man that loves me.
All right. That's the secret.
That's it. And when you look for him, if he loves God, he going to love you.
Hallelujah.
That's a good man. Okay? I ain't talking about these fake ones. Okay? They could be in the church. They could be in the church and they, oh yeah, I love the Lord. But do you really love the Lord?
Amen.
You know, what are you doing? What are you, show me. You know, and you got sense, you know, wisdom. Ask God, give me some wisdom. And you know, it comes, that comes. All that comes. My cousin was crying her heart out. And my mom said, you gonna get married, you gonna get married. And she did. And she praise the Lord, she had a good husband. But he loved the Lord. And
then
he's going to church. I'm telling you. And that's a good thing, because any man that loves God is gonna love you. That's it. And you ain't got nothing to worry about. Because he's, you know what? Because he has humbled himself into God. And he's following God's ways. And he's going to keep God's commandment. He's going to do his best to do right. And he's doing right by God, he's going to do right by you. Okay, we are done with this here. Remember, God owns everything. He was
will take care of our enemies. It's funny because as long as we stay with Jesus, the enemy can't hurt us. Okay? The joy of the Lord is our strength. Yes. Remember that now. The joy of our Lord is our strength. Yes. And one more thing, and I'm going to pass out something to everyone. Proverbs. Let's go to Proverbs, Pastor. Okay. Proverbs chapter 3. And we're going to go to 6 and 9. And I'm going to pass
Proverbs chapter 3.
Proverbs, it's on it. Proverbs chapter 3.
Okay, one verse.
Verse 6.
Okay, double check, make sure. 6. There we go.
And all that way.
Okay, in all that way, acknowledge him. And he shall already have a hand. And the 7th, be not mine.
Shall be help to thy neighbor, and marrow to thy bone. Right, number 9. Honor the Lord with thy substance, and with the first fruits of all thy increase.
Okay, what it's saying, y'all read some of that, read it at home, but when you honor God, that is going to heal us. That's our help. It's good for our help to honor him. Remember now, if you honor God and acknowledge him, we will be healthy. We are going to get healthy. I'm telling you, we're going to have strong bones. We're going to have better blood pressure. Everything is going to be much better for us because that's our help. Our help it comes from God. So if we do these things, acknowledge him, and do all these things he already told you, and y'all go home and read that again, it's going to be help. It's help for us. That's giving us good help. Good lungs, good stomach problems, whatever, mind, all this. It's going to be good because that is our nourishment. That's, I know people have to take medication, but that's like popping a pill every day and do it 3 times a day, Get God inside of us, his words inside of us. And I'm telling you, we're going to be healthy people in 2022. We won't have any bad headaches, these nerve conditions,
amen.
All this stuff going on in our life. All that stuff will be out the door. Because by God said, I'm your deliverer. Jesus Christ is our deliverer. And he's giving us something right now that 2022, we're going to start, we're going to have good help. And now you're coming from sharing, because I'm listening to that God. I want to get this for myself. I'm telling you, I'm eating all this stuff. I'm going to go home, and I'm going to read it. I'm telling you. Okay, this is something new. So anyway, thank you.
coming.
Reverend.
I'm coming.
Come. Okay.
All right.
Yeah. Amen. Amen. And I go to work among some devils. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. And I put the devil in God's hand, and let God deal with them. Amen. Praise the Lord. So I'm telling you, this is how you manage things. Amen. Praise the Lord. You have to put God first in everything you do. Amen. Praise the Lord. You know, I got my anxiety I went through. Amen. To God, what? Cool. Amen. Give me the spirit. So I can work through that. Amen. I have to have people to make me angry. Amen. Praise the Lord. Give me the spirit, God. Amen. So I can manage the anger. The Bible says get angry and say not. Amen. You got to understand that. And that's how you live your life. Amen. They're going to expect for you. Amen. To take it and to put up with it.
Yeah.
Because you claim that you belong to God.
Yeah.
Amen. And I'm going to finish up. Amen. Well, we do a good time now. Amen. Praise the Lord. I'll talk a little bit longer. I had experienced. Amen. I tell you, a method. I get my knowledge about messages from an English. Amen. 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 I'm going to stop y'all because I'm not ready. Amen. Praise the Lord. I was talking to one of my co-workers. Amen. He said that he was a Christian. He's from Egypt. Amen. He said, you're a Christian. I said, you're a Christian. What kind of Christian are you? He said, I'm an Orthodox Christian. I said, you're Orthodox, you know what you mean? He said, no, I'm an Orthodox Christian. And I said, well, I know about Orthodox Jews, but I don't know if I know about Orthodox Christian. Amen. Praise the Lord. He said, well, I'm Egyptian and you're American. Amen. Praise the Lord. Now, you know me. All right? I had to go look that up. And I looked it up. Amen. Praise the Lord. Glory, hallelujah, and I understand and respect him. I asked him, I said, do you believe in Jesus? Yeah, we believe in Jesus.
Uh-huh.
I said, well, I know, amen, praise the Lord, you are a friend of mine. I know that you serve the same Father I do because you believe in Jesus.
Yeah.
But I looked it up anyway. I want to know what an Orthodox Christian was. And I found out, amen, praise the Lord, that it was the largest, number two, amen, of all the Christians, amen, praise the Lord, denominations, or I should say organization, they are the second largest. Amen, praise the Lord. And you know, when we talk, we read about Egyptians, we read about Egyptians and Israelites and how they was in bondage and so forth and so on. And amen, praise the Lord. But here we have a man that said, well, I'm Egyptian.
Yeah.
Amen, praise the Lord. And he said he was Egyptian, he was a Christian. Amen, praise the Lord. Glory, hallelujah. He identified with me. Amen, praise the Lord. And I identified with him. Amen. As long as we've been working together over a year now, amen, praise the Lord. He was telling me he was Christian, so I finally called him out of him. Amen, praise the Lord. But you see, you never know how God, amen, will put you in the place and to meet some other people. Amen.
Amen.
You remember the scripture says, those that are not against us, come on, saints.
Yeah,
those are not against us, what? For us. Amen. That's not Jesus. That's the way I handle it. Amen. For those not against us is for us. And I want to share that with you today. Amen. Praise the Lord. So you know my father, amen, our church have had Egyptians in it. Christian Egyptians, remember?
Yeah.
Southern pastor. We had Egyptians, amen, ordained in our church as Christians. Amen. And it brought back the memory, amen, praise the Lord, that how my father, it would come and visit him, amen, praise he would pray with him, amen, praise the Lord, and do things with him, amen, and praise the Lord. So, you know, it sometimes I see how vast what the church is and how vast my father was in dealing with people, because he don't care who they were, amen, praise the Lord, he would deal with it, amen, amen, praise the Lord. And you know, and now here am I dealing with what? Egyptian, and it dawned on me, my dad's been dealing with them for many years. Amen. They were Christians. And I'm a young boy, I didn't know that, but I started to think about it. Amen. Here's one God gonna put there right by me to help me. Amen. I to help him. Isn't that something? See, that's how God works. Hallelujah. Now, all right, now we got a few more minutes, but we're gonna go ahead and stand in this mess. Amen, praise the Lord. Amen. Blessing, honor, glory, wisdom.